I was discussing with a friend a few moments ago, and I said, before I'm up to this age, I am now. When people say someone has reached up to 40 years, I look like, wow, 50 years. I say, wow, they're old people. But look at you and myself now. Because you are in that age, you feel like you are still 16. We're not deceiving ourselves. We are going low. We are going gradually. And that is why it is very, very important to know that what we have in life is moments. Moments. No time. Any moment you have, use it to impact people's life. Let people cherish you. Let people remember you for something good. Let people see you as someone adorable. Even when you have no money, let your face radiate happiness and joy. That is what life is all about. And that is why the best thing we can do in life is to bless ourselves in the hands of God. Because if we are not in the hands of God, we are lost. When was the last time you went to church? We are so busy. Some nice people only go to church on occasions for birthdays and working. That's all. You can't cope with Him. So you can't learn how to do it now. And not just you, your family, your children, train them. I was so much edified. I was very happy. Though sad when I learned of Igwe's death. Because the first thing Nzechike and the Lord did was to call me, Father, we have to save us. We have to save us, Father, you have to save. It's like every day he wants to come to my house to make sure everything is ready for the mass. Because something was given to them as a value. If not, they will just throw a party. That's it. The king is popular, he doesn't need prayer. No, but because something more than material was given to the in-law and the daughter, and they know that what Papa needs now is prayer. Think about it. That was why I said today, no matter I have so many other things lined up, I must make it come here. In fact, I tell you now, I'm from ordination to a 50th birthday, and here now I'm going to another 50th birthday. Just to tell you, when I had it, I said, it's good to have this kind of value in people. Think about it. If you are sick, will your children call a priest for you? So what are you spending? You are keeping money for them. Buying land in Abuja, Lagos and Abuja, and writing it in their name, just the paperwork. What are you talking about? You can't even tell them to go to church. You are afraid because they're going to scold you. So what are you doing? Who are you to them? Listen to me, dear friends. You go to just wasting time here. A good number of us left Nigeria, sold a lot of things, came here many years ago, struggling, sweating, early in the morning, buying the car, boom, 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 boom. No rest. Only to end up not putting anything inside the jewelry, but only accumulating material things. No child born here will ever be poor. You know that? Because they have social security. You and I, you know how we started, you know how far. So why are you talking yourself about people who are already secured? What you need to do is put values into their lives. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that is why, when we reflect on what we need to do, the best thing to do is to put ourselves in the hands of God. I take you to a familiar thing you know so well. Well, something happened a few days ago. My Lord King Joshua was defeated. Oh. When you see Joshua carrying the gloves and he goes into the ring, that is money, isn't it? But now, if you give me the same gloves, I'm not able to make money with it. And the difference is, in whose hands are the gloves? When you give me a racket, I play more tennis. I can go into the long walk and jump around. I can only sweat at the end. Give the same racket to Serena Williams. You know what it means? Billions of pounds. What's the difference? Mm-hmm. It depends on whose hands the racket is not placed. Remember Moses in the Bible?
A stick, a rod was given to him by God. Strike the waters. He divided into two. And the Israelites passed through. Give you the same rod, give me the same rod. Put it on the water. Water will be smiling. What's the difference? It depends on whose hands the rod or the stick is placed. A single stone which kind of was David and Goliath, the giant on the floor. Give me the same rod. Maybe I just kill a bird with it and you'll be clapping for me. The difference, it depends on whose hands the stones are placed. Look at Jesus himself. Two fish and five loaves. Put it on my table. Not up to breakfast, but with Jesus. He fed 4,000 and 5,000. What is the difference? It depends on whose hands the loaves of bread and fish are put into. Look at the nails in the hands of Jesus and his feet. And put the seven nails in my hand and feet. You call ambulance immediately for emergency before I contact the tetanus and disease. But in the hands of Jesus, that is the definition of our salvation. What is the difference? It depends on whose hands the nails are placed. No wonder the word of God says in the book of Wisdom, chapter 1, 3, the verse number 1, that the souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, because the hand is the organ of organs. And that is why the apostles, they place their hand on people, they are healed, the hand. And Jesus himself, when he was about to die, he cried up and said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. St. Thomas Aquinas says, the hand is the organ of organs. And so what is the message? As we are now healthy, at least being able to come out of our homes, beloved in Christ, the best thing you need to do and I need to do is to put yourself, now you are alive, in the hands of God. Sometimes we spend a lot of energy trying to please people, trying to connect with people, doing politics and all that, and losing the mechanism of life, connecting with God. If you put yourself in the hands of people who are not with God, they will mislead you. And you never know, when you die, they might repent. That's the irony of life. So today, God wants you and I to see this coming together. What even will lie is that on his video mass and working, a good number of people decided to be better human beings. A good number of people decided. You had the first reading, the second reading, he says, the life of each and every one of us has influence on the other. You know what? Christianity is measured to the extent we can open our hands to accept them into our lives. And that is why today, dear friends, I want to encourage you that our coming together today is to first of all thank God for the gift of his life, and also to ask ourselves what we can do to make life better. Sometimes when our dear ones die, we cry and we weep. Why do people cry at times? I ask myself. Sometimes they cry. We do not have enough money for their funeral. They cry. Sometimes they cry because they love this person so much. They have no time to spend. They were so busy. Think about it. When was the last time you called Nigeria? Because they asked you for money, you have stopped calling all of them. But if they let them, you book flight and you go back home. Think about that. You know, sometimes they can be so troubling, but if you become like them, then you think differently. That is why, don't judge people the way they are. When people do things, even when you don't understand, it could be an unconscious cry for help. So if you know better, minister to the person with the Spirit of God, and I'm telling you, you're going to be happy for it. Because the more you are able to be a Jesus to people, to write it the glory of God, the more you still fulfill it, which is not based on material things. And you're going to be proper. Because cheerfulness and happiness
prolongs your life. And you know what? You have nothing to lose because you are pleasing your God and you are pleasing yourself. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And that is why I will encourage you, beloved in Christ, to take time to enjoy the companionship of those God has put into your hands, either by blood or by baptism or by contact. Take time to enjoy their companionship. Some people die because they wanted, when they make enough money, then they will be able to have time with them. But no one is God. And that is why I came across this poem, which I think is very, very nice, that we listen to it. And I read the way it is, but I didn't write it. It says, "When you are dead, your tears will flow, but I won't know. Cry for me now instead. You will send me flowers, but I won't see. Send those flowers now instead. You will say words of praise, but I won't hear those praise. So praise me now instead. When I die, you will forget my faults. I will know. Why not forget my faults now instead? When I die, you will miss me, but I won't feel it. Miss me now instead. You will wish you would have spent more time with me. Spend it now instead. You will wish you could have spent all your money on me. Spend now instead. When you hear I'm gone, you will find a way to my house. Pay compliments, but we haven't even spoken in years. Please, look for me now. Spend time with every person around you and help them with whatever you have to make them happy. Your family, your friends, your acquaintances. Make them feel special because you never know when time will take them away from you forever. Life is too short to be wasted in procrastination." Let us thank the good Lord for coming together today and let it mark a new beginning in our lives to know that we are nothing without Jesus and the life we live has meaning to the extent we are able to impact on the life of others. We commend Igwe Nwachukwu and into God's hands with a short word that God will grant him eternal rest. May the soul of Igwe Nwachukwu and then the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. I want to dedicate this song to him from my great singer. From a great singer I know so much, and a good number of you may also know him. He says, "Precious Lord, take my hands." Jim Reeves says, "When my way groweth near, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, yeah, grant, hear my call. Put my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me May we stand, please. Prayers for the faithful. God the Almighty, Father, raise Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Emmanuel, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
Oh. Mm-hmm.